So here we have a triangle ABC in which AB equals AC. BO bisects angle B. See here, BO bisects angle B. That means angle B is divided into two equal angles, ABO and CBO. These are the two equal halves of angle B. CO bisects angle C. So this is angle C. CO bisects angle C, which means angle C is divided into two equal angles, ACO and angle BCO. See here, I have marked the equal angles in both the cases. See here, I have marked the equal angles in both the cases. So given this, we need to prove that OB equals OC. Let's do this first. Now we know that AC equals AB. This is given to us. AC equals AB in triangle ABC is given to us. So this means, now in a triangle when two sides are equal, the angles opposite to them are also equal. Now look at the triangle ABC without the line segments OA, OB and OC. Just look at the triangle ABC without these segments. Now which is the angle opposite of the side AC? Which is the angle opposite to the side AC? Angle ABC, this one. Angle ABC, this is the angle opposite to this side. Write out that, angle ABC. Now which is the angle opposite of the side AB? This is the side AB and this is the angle opposite to the side AB, which is angle ACB. So what are we trying to do here? In a triangle when two sides are equal, the angles opposite to them are also equal. This is a property in an isosceles triangle. This one is triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle because we have two equal sides. So in an isosceles triangle where two sides are equal, the angles opposite to the equal sides are also equal. So that's how we have this result. Now we know that halves of equals are also equal. So half of angle ABC is equal to half of angle ACB. Now what is half of angle ABC? This is angle ABC. What is half of this angle? We know it's bisected. We know angle ABC is bisected. So half of angle ABC is angle 3. I have marked 3 here. Is angle 3. And what is half of angle ACB? This is angle ACB. Again, angle ACB is also bisected. So half of angle ACB is angle 4. What I marked here, angle 4. So like this, we have a new result. Angle 3 equals angle 4. Angle 3 equals angle 4. And where are these two angles? In triangle BOC. Where do we find angles 3 and 4? In triangle BOC. Alright, so we have a new result. Angle 3 equals angle 4 in triangle BOC. Again, apply the isosceles triangle property. In a triangle, when two angles are equal, the sides opposite to them are also equal. So which is the triangle here? OBC. Which are the equal angles? Angle 3 and angle 4. Now which is the side opposite to angle 3? OC. Which is the side opposite to angle 4? OB. So in triangle BOC, since angle 3 equals angle 4, the side opposite to angle 3 will be equal to the side opposite to angle 4. And that's how we have the result, OC equals OB. Alright, OC is the side opposite to angle 3. OB is the side opposite to angle 4. So now we have OC equals OB in triangle BOC. And that's what we had to prove, OC equals OB or OB equals OC. We also need to show that AO bisects angle A. AO bisects angle A. See here, this is the line segment AO. We need to prove that AO bisects this angle A. That means we need to show that angle 1 equals angle 2. So to show that angle 1 equals angle 2, angle 1 is an angle in triangle ABO. Angle 2 is an angle in triangle ACO. So we simply have to show that these two triangles are congruent to each other. And once we prove they are congruent, their corresponding angles are equal, and that way we can show that angle 1 equals angle 2. So now let's take up the two triangles AOB and AOC. You can name it any way. You can call it ABO, ACO, whatever. So here you can see it. Take up the two triangles AOB and AOC. Alright. Now in these two triangles, you will see that AO is the common side. AO is a side common to both the triangles. OB is equal to OC. OB of this triangle equals OC of this triangle. We just proved earlier that OB equals OC. And AB of this first triangle equals AC of the second triangle is also given to us. Alright. So what have we listed? We have listed three pairs of equal sides. Three pairs of equal sides. So by the SSS congruence criterion, triangle AOB is congruent to triangle AOC. So how do you name the triangles? So see here, you can take up any two pairs of equal sides. If you take up these two, see here, AOOB. So AOB, AOB, AOOC, AOC. Alright, so triangle AOB is congruent to triangle AOC by the SSS congruence criterion. And now that we've proved the triangles are congruent, their corresponding angles are equal. So see here, angle A of the first triangle is equal to angle A of the second triangle. Angle A of triangle AOB equals angle A of triangle AOC. Let's check that. Which is angle A of triangle AOB. AOB, angle A, see here, angle 1. And which is angle A of triangle AOC? See here, this portion, angle 2. This part of A lies in the first triangle. This part of A lies in the second triangle. So now that the triangles are congruent, angle A of the first triangle equals angle A of the second triangle, which means angle 1 equals angle 2. If angle 1 equals angle 2, it clearly means that AO, the line segment AO, bisects the vertical angle A. Correct? If angle 1 equals angle 2, it means the line segment AO bisects the angle A.